SharpC is a project funded by the National Coordinator for Health Information Technology. Its primary goal is to address the usability, workflow, and cognitive support issues in the adoption and meaningful use of electronic health records. The University of Texas Health Science Center at Houston is the home for SharpC, which has 9 partners across the country. SharpC operates under the National Center for Cognitive Informatics and Decision-Making in Healthcare at the university. Dr. Zhaoji Zhang, Professor and Associate Dean of Research at the University's School of Biomedical Informatics, is a principal investigator of SharpC. SharpC is composed of 5 research projects that address the cognitive challenges in health information technology.
SharpC was created to serve as ONC's national center to provide strategic leadership in EHR usability, workflow, and cognitive support. Our purpose is to use information technology to support safer, better, and more efficient care for all Americans. We have the vision, the science, and tools, and with the support of ONC, we are able to progress towards a high-performing, adaptive, nationwide healthcare system.
One of the biggest challenges preventing widespread adoption of electronic health records are that they're not really designed to fit the work of healthcare providers. Many clinicians have to change the way they work to fit the design of the EHR. In our project, we are developing the methods and tools to facilitate work-centered design. Our work is based on decades of research in human factors and human-computer interaction. Usability is one of our key focus areas. Poor EHR usability can have devastating consequences, such as causing a medication to be ordered for the wrong patient. In our lab, we conduct assessments of commercial EHRs and provide detailed feedback to vendors on usability challenges we discover. In our simulation facilities, we can model healthcare environments and can test how EHRs can handle realistic clinical scenarios. We are also developing software tools that can help conduct comprehensive usability assessments and to capture, redesign, and improve workflow. We expect that our work can help in the development of EHRs that can reach their enormous potential to be usable, useful, and optimized to fit the workflow of healthcare providers and their patients.
So the motivation behind our project, Cognitive Foundations for Clinical Decision Making, is the belief that clinicians' attention is a precious resource. That resource is currently consumed by the task of synthesizing and aggregating information from different resources, because the information that's needed to support clinical decision making is scattered across the EHR, across paper notes, across different instruments. This would be something like trying to solve a jigsaw puzzle by drawing pieces independently without a sense of the big picture. But that's not the way in which we solve jigsaw puzzles. So what we tend to do is assemble smaller parts of the picture in groups, and we find the pieces that are relevant to those parts. And this is what physicians who are good at what they're doing, research has shown, do when they're trying to understand a patient's situation. So they find pieces of the puzzle that make sense together. What we're trying to do in our project is design tools that take on the burden of some of that work. We build tools that have embedded in them the organization of knowledge that physicians use in practice to solve problems, so that physicians no longer have to do that work. The problem is presented to them by our tools in a form that's conducive to their coming to a solution.
Our goal is to promote the widespread adoption of clinical decision support by making it easier for sites to adopt best practice clinical decision support rules and customize them to their local environment and workflows. Customizing clinical decision support rules is traditionally a time-consuming process that has proven difficult for smaller practices to handle. In our project, we are trying to overcome this barrier by identifying the types of variations in clinical decision support implementation among sites, which we call setting-specific factors, and then building an implementer's workbench to allow users to modify a generalized rule by choosing the setting-specific factors that pertain to their practice. This approach has a significant advantage in that it allows users to adopt a common rule based on agreement on the general clinical content expressed within, and then to modify that rule so that it best accommodates their local workflow and preferences. Another aspect of this approach that we have been pursuing is to work with EHR vendors to ensure that the output of the implementer's workbench can be deployed within the user's electronic health record.
Clinical summarization is particularly important for clinicians when they're looking at the patient record, because right now they're into a situation where they get a lot of cognitive overload because the system is organized according to data types. So all the medications are on one screen, all the laboratory test results on another screen, the problems on another screen. It's difficult for them to switch back and forth between these screens and put the information together. So a particularly important part of this project is how we create the knowledge that's required to make these screens. And so we have two basic methodologies to do that. One is we're interviewing clinicians and asking them to explain their knowledge, and then we've built a program that allows us to store that knowledge on the computer system so it can be used later by the computer interface. The other method we're using is a data mining technique where we look through large amounts of data to see what's happened in the past and use some machine learning algorithms to understand these relationships between the problems and the medications and the problems and the laboratory test results.
One of our main goals is to create innovative ways to visualize health information. Cognitive information design and visualization tackles the difficult problem of integrating information from different vendors, different systems, with different meanings and different intended audiences. We have a strong theoretical framework called CIFSA that underpins our design work. Properly designed information workflows will allow us to deliver better, safer care faster. We are also in the process of building strong relationships with the vendor community. As an example, one of our innovative user interfaces is currently being experimentally integrated into a major vendor's electronic health record solution. Our medication reconciliation algorithm and user interfaces form the user-facing part of the PanSharp project. The PanSharp project brings innovations from five of the most advanced healthcare IT projects to clinical personnel in the United States within a short couple of years.
We look forward to supporting the healthcare industry in supplying the best care and the safest care for all Americans. We are thankful to all the efforts that make this work possible.